So today in the morning, you know, like I had discussed those two stories about flying. It was the first flight and the second one was the black aeroplane. Okay. And so you have read those stories and we know that one, it is about a very common experience here. So it is here we have the little seagull telling or the writer telling about the seagull afraid to fly and how finally it finds strength in its wings. And it's just that moment of fear. And you have to overcome that fear when you start learning or doing something new, right? And how I was just afraid of looking at the deep blue sea and the right, once the bird starts learning how to fly, does not feel afraid at all. In fact, it becomes so tired that it goes and sits on that green flooring or the green expanse of the sea. Right. And so it's not afraid at all. And how, yes, the behavior of the siblings, behavior of the mother and the father. Father was there busy, you know, teaching the other siblings to fly. And they were ignoring the little bird and the mother, they brought the fish. And the little bird was so hungry that in its hunger just jumped towards that fish and just forgot his, you know, like, what, where am I? And kind of just jumped out. Okay, and spread his wings and started to fly. Second was about the black aeroplane, and right, it was about the writer talking about his, you know, very strange experience that he had, and he was in a hurry to reach home, and he took a big risk. The first risk was that, yes, he was on the last engine full of fuel, but even then he took the risk of flying from, you know, like Paris towards England, yes. And quite late at night, and there in the sky, what happens, he's caught in the middle of the storm. There's these thick clouds and he has to either fly around them or fly, you know, like through them. And he takes a big risk of flying through them. First of all, he's a little hesitant, but then he sees this little black aeroplane right there in front of him and follows the aeroplane. The aeroplane does not have any lights on it, but the pilot was visible, waving his hand and asking him to follow him. So he follows that aeroplane. And yes, what are the other strange things that happened? That is, you know, all the panel on the board there, you know, in the cockpit, everything, it stopped working. So the needles were not moving, the compass not functioning. And he was there, of course, afraid of losing out on the fuel also. And he follows the aeroplane, and before that, before takeoff, he is there, you know, talking to the clock, the radio tower, and he's informing about his flight, and he's connected with them, and so, you know, to make them aware. Naturally, it's a protocol which they're supposed to do. And when he comes out of the plane, when he sees the runway, like the landing, and when he has to land over there, and he just waits because he wants to say a thank you to the pilot of that black aeroplane. Why black aeroplane? It was because it was without lights, that darkness, right? And you could just see that, yes, there was the aeroplane over there, not because it was black colored, right? And so he lands on the runway and he wants to thank the man, wants to thank the pilot, but to his surprise, he comes to know that there was no other plane on the radar that night. So his was the only plane that was flying, right? So, yes, so he's unable, you know, like to understand what had happened and how this mystery was there and how, you know, like he was able to come out of the storm and out of the dark clouds, right? So these two stories about flying, one about the bird flying and one about the pilot flying, both of them very, you know, interesting in their own sweet ways. Now we come to the next story, that is about the invisible man. And so we have quite just a few more days in which, let's see, then one day I'll finish the other two chapters also. It's just a discussion. We have read them in detail, so you know that. Now, how did the invisible man first become visible? How did he become visible? How did the invisible man become visible? Can anybody tell me? How did the visible man become invisible? So we're talking about Griffin. He was a scientist and he discovered a formula for invisibility, made himself invisible. And then how did he become visible again? How did he become visible? Yes, by his experiments. He wore clothes. Very nice, Jasleen. It's good to see you, right? And Jaya has also joined us. And right, so he wrapped those bandages around his face. He wore a hat. He made his costume, right? Of course, which he got and by stealing, yes. And he wore the clothes, and he was visible again, right? So once again, we think that when he had become invisible, why did he want to become visible again? Yeah, why did he want to become visible? Anybody? Why did he want to become visible? Because it was so cold and he could not survive in that cold weather without clothes. Yes, it was raining and there was snow around and it was quite cold weather. And so he had to keep himself warm. And right, yes, so there are little details that he noticed. We do notice, you know, that he was always sniffling as if he's caught a cold. And that, how did that happen? Because he was invisible and he was without clothes. And so because of that, the weather did affect him in that way. Okay. So, yes. So what is it over here that we notice? The two boys, they started in surprise at the fresh muddy imprints of bare feet here. And right. So here we notice that what is it? So whose footprints were there? Footprints without feet. Can you explain the title? We've got the title from The Invisible Man. So his footprints are there, but the feet are not visible. Yes, it's Invisible Man here, right? So where was the man? What had happened to the man? Why was he not visible? Because he had done his experiments and he had become invisible, right? Yes. Right, Shantanu, it is Griffin. Now here, further footprints, they followed one after another, descending the steps and progressing down the street. Some rare drugs, he only had made those drugs, you know, he only had made them. Nishtha, he only had done the experiment. What was the experiment here? When you do those experiments in the laboratory here, you know, like, yeah, you want some kind of product, you want some kind of solution. You mix a few things here. You know what you're mixing. Right? So who had made those drugs? This man only had made those drugs. So if you read the whole book, no, you will find that first he did his experiments, you know, like on a piece of wool and then on a cat also, then finally he did it. And it was a long procedure, you know, when he really felt very uncomfortable, but then even then he did not give up. Okay? Right? So it is that he only had made those. Right, he had done that experiment and he has made those drugs. Yes. Now here, what is the mystery that is being spoken about? Can you just tell me over here? The explanation of the mystery was really simply what is the mystery being discussed? What's the mystery here in this line? What is the mystery? The mystery of the footprints without feet. Okay. The boys did not know, but we know that the bewildered boys. What is the meaning of bewildered? What's the meaning of bewildered? Someone? What is bewildered? Yes? Bewildered means the surprised boys. You know, they're so, surprised to see that there are feet, but there's no person. So it is quite scary also. Had been following a scientist who had just discovered how to make the human body transparent. So what otherwise is our body transparent? What do we call it, right? Can light pass through? No, it is not. So what is our body? Is it translucent? Is it opaque? Or is it transparent? You know that in your sciences, you've done that. So it is opaque, yes. So our human body is opaque, okay? Now here, Griffin, the scientist, had carried out experiment after experiment to prove that the human body could become invisible. So he had been working as a very, see, he is, they're a very intelligent person and he has been working on this experiment and he had been working on this experiment for a long time and he swallowed certain rare drugs and his body became as transparent as a sheet of glass. though it also remained as solid as glass. So, you know, like here we thought that, yes, the man has become invisible. Within becoming invisible, what had happened to the body in its appearance? It's become transparent. Okay. And yes, so even though it is transparent, has it become soft? It is as solid as glass. So nothing has changed as such with the, you know, like the condition of the body. But what has happened, you know, all the things, you know, the vessels and the nerves and the muscles and all, what have they become? They have become transparent. Okay. Right. So here, though it also remained as solid as glass. What remained as solid as glass? The body. Okay. Right. Now, brilliant scientist, though he was rather a lawless person. So see here, there's a contrast. He was brilliant, but he was lawless. What made him lawless? What made the person here lawless? Yes. What made him lawless? His greed or his need also. First, it was his need. Right. Later on, yeah, he became greedy because he realized that his power is there. He has a special power. He has a secret, that is his invisibility. Okay. Now his landlord disliked him and tried to eject him. Eject means remove. In revenge, Griffin set fire to the house. Now these are the examples of his lawlessness. See, he was brilliant. But do we really admire his brilliance? Because no, he's not a law-abiding person. And we know that he is not going to use his power in a nice way. Okay, right. So we have here. Wait, who haven't entered right now? So he's a lawless person. Okay. And so he, in revenge, he set fire to the house. To get away without being seen, he had to remove his clothes. He became a homeless wanderer, without clothes, without money, and quite invisible, until he happened to step in some mud and left footprints as he walked. So we are talking about how did he come to be in this position? How is it that the boys were able to see? So what were the sequence of events? What has he done to his landlord's house? He put it on fire, right? Because the landlord did not like him. He wanted to send him away. He wanted him to vacate his house. In return, what did Griffin do? He put his house on fire. Okay. And now he is out walking without clothes on the streets. And it's raining. So his muddy feet are appearing as footprints. He escaped easy enough from the boys who followed his footprints in London. But his adventures were by no means over. He had chosen a bad time of the year to wander about London without clothes. It was midwinter. The air was bitterly cold and he could not do without clothes. Instead of walking about the streets, he decided to slip into a big London store for warmth. So from one step to the other, he's become homeless. What has he done to his house? He's burnt it down. He's left it now. He's going away from there. And because he doesn't have a choice. And now he's gone to a London store. What happens over there in the London store? Can anybody tell me? So here in the London store, he wanted, to get some clothes. And so he, like when the store was shut, he was able to, you know, like wear clothes. And he went to the other places which are there in the departmental store, the food section. He had food over there. And so he just went off to sleep. So he became very comfortable, very warm, but he woke up a little late. What had happened by the time? The attendants or the assistants, they were coming and they saw this man lying over there and a lot of, noise was there and they wanted to catch him because this thief has entered. So one thing is very, very sure that once you do something wrong, you end up doing more wrongs, right? So once, what had he done? He's burned the house down and he's now, you know, left that place and now he's come to the store. From there also, he is running away, okay? Right, because he's being chased away rather. Now, so once more, he found himself invisible but naked in the chill January air. So not a pleasant time to be without clothes. So he wanted to wear those clothes, but he had to give them away and he had to take them off. And the only way he could become invisible was by removing his clothes. So now he decided to try the stock of a theatrical company in the hope of finding not only clothes, but also something that would hide the empty space above his shoulders. What is an empty space above his shoulders? What could be that? What have he been covering till now? And what has he decided to cover even more now? Can anybody tell me what is the empty space above his shoulders? What is there above our shoulders? A head, right? So we all know what Griffin did to cover his face, yes? So shivering with cold, he hurried to Drury Lane, the center of the theater world. So it's a very important place, you know, known in the world of theater for all the, you know, like costumes there and the theater lovers, they go there, artists there looking for costumes and all. So he went to Drury Lane. And so he decided that he has to, you know, cover himself. He needs to cover his face as well. So he found a suitable shop. He made his way invisible upstairs and came out a little later wearing bandages around his forehead, dark glasses, false nose, big bushy side whiskers and a large hat. So he's reached the right place. He's reached a theatrical company where he can find things to cover his face. Okay. So otherwise he would be roaming around like a headless person if he had not covered his head. Okay. Right. Yeah, and we know that here, but yes, you have to read all this very, very carefully. Just look at this all here. Big bushy side whiskers, large hat. These are the things that he had found. And where did he find them? Where did he find all these theatrical items? Which place? Drury Lane, right? And of course, what other act of violence or what other act of lawlessness did he do? Yes, in this theatrical costume shop, what did he do? He callously attacked the shopkeeper from behind. One, he did this. Second was, after which he robbed him of all the money he could find. So he is now definitely, you know, in the deep of that lawlessness now. He's done so many wrong things. And so there's one thing right that he did, one thing brilliantly that he did. Yeah, that he's a scientist. He's worked very hard. He's discovered this formula of invisibility. But now what has he done? He's done so many wrongs that we really don't admire his intelligence. We really, you know, like, of course, thinking of him as a very negative, as a very bad person. Okay, right. Now, why does Mrs. Hall find the scientist eccentric? What do you think is eccentric? Eccentric means? What does it mean, eccentric? What does eccentric mean? Crazy, little mad, okay? Right, so what curious episode occurs in the study? Let's just go over here and just find out. So eager to get away from the crowded London, he took a train to the village of Iping, where he booked two rooms at the local inn. So he's got money. Where did he get the money from? He robbed the shop. What did he do to the shopkeeper? Very bad, he attacked him. Right, injured him, and he's ran away with all the money he could find. So arrival of a stranger at an inn in winter was in any case an unusual event. A stranger of such uncommon appearance set all tongues wagging. Mrs. Hall, the landlord's wife, made every effort to be friendly, but Griffin had no desire to talk. He didn't want to talk. His appearance was strange. He was always indoor, and he said, I've had an accident. I don't want to be disturbed. So his behavior was thought to be eccentric. Satisfied that her guest was an eccentric scientist, and in view of the fact that he had paid her in advance, Mrs. Hall was prepared to excuse his strange habits and irritable temper. What are the strange habits of Griffin? What are the strange habits? That he wanted to be alone. He did not mix up with people much. He was a little rude also. And he had a very strange appearance, right? A bandaged face and all. And what did he tell people? What had happened to him? What did he tell people? That why was he wearing the bandage? He had met with an accident, right? Yes. Now, he was satisfied that a guest was an eccentric scientist. So are all scientists eccentric according to this? So not all scientists are eccentric, but here, because of his behavior, that is why. And in view of the fact that he had paid her in advance, he's paid her the rent in advance, so Mrs. Hall was ready to tolerate him, was prepared to excuse his strange habits and irritable temper. But the stolen money did not last long, and presently Griffin had to admit that he had no more ready cash. He pretended, however, that he was expecting a check to arrive at any moment. What had happened to the money? Why did he have no more ready cash? His money had finished and he's paid, spent all the money which he had stolen from the costume shop, right? And now he's pretending that I'm waiting for a check to arrive, and when the check arrives, I will be able to pay my dues. I'll be able to pay more money. Is he telling the truth or is he lying? He doesn't have a job. He doesn't have a source of income. Where does he get his money from? Where does he get the money from? From stealing. Okay. And that is also over. Now, shortly afterwards, a curious episode occurred very early in the morning. A clergyman and his wife were awakened by noises in the study. Creeping downstairs, they heard the chink of money being taken from the clergyman's house. What do you think is chink? What does chink mean? What could be the meaning of chink here in this context? Yes, they heard the chink of money. Chink, is it sound? Yes, very nice. Yes, chink is the sound of money. It's the coin. So when you take out a coin here, so they make that sound, isn't it right? So it is there. Not exactly an appropriate word, but yes, so it is the chink here. It is a sound word. Without making any noise and with the poker grasped firmly in his hand, the clergyman opened the door. So they heard the sound and they immediately went downstairs and they asked to surrender. Whom did they ask to surrender? Why had they come down? Why had the clergyman come down? Because they heard sound, right? And whom did they expect to see? Yes. Whom did they expect to see in their room? A thief? An intruder? What did they see instead? Nothing. There was emptiness. And why couldn't they see anyone? Why were they unable to see anyone? Because there was no one? Because what had happened to the, the sound was of the thief and it was because he was invisible. I have only one person answering and the others are there nicely sleeping. Is it? So he realized who the clergyman, he realized that the room appeared to be empty. He and his wife looked under the desk and behind the curtains and even up the chimney. There wasn't a sign of anybody. Why couldn't they find anybody? Why couldn't they find anybody? Because Ryan, they couldn't see anyone. Yet the desk had been opened and the housekeeping money was missing. And yes, so someone had opened the desk and the money was missing. Strange, they couldn't see anyone, but there has been a theft. Extraordinary affair, the clergyman kept saying for the rest of the day. That very strange. How did it happen? But it was not as extraordinary as the behavior of Mrs. Hall's furniture a little later that morning. So we have read here, what happened to Mrs. Hall's furniture? What did the furniture do? Yes, started jumping and moving around. And who was doing that? It was Griffin, right? And so what had happened was Griffin had been away. Now, according to all these circumstances, according to all the events described here, where do you think the invisible man was? In the morning when Mr. and Mrs. Hall, they were making preparations for another event here. Where do you think the invisible man was? He was at the clergyman's house, right? And he was there busy stealing their money. And in the morning, he came back. But Mr. and Mrs. Hall did not see him. And so Mrs. Hall, she went over there. She saw that, that man was not there. And what else was there? His bandages were lying about. And so why is it's very significant. He's left his bandages. He never, ever showed his face to anybody. And he said that he's met with an accident. He would not remove the bandages. Now, all of a sudden, Mrs. Hall heard a sniff close to here. When do we sniff? A sniff. You have a cold, right? Yeah. And so she heard a sniff here. So who was that person sniffing? The invisible man. A moment later, the hat on the bedpost leapt up and dashed itself into her face. Why do you think the furniture was behaving strangely? We know it was invisible man. What was he trying to do by making the, throwing the furniture at them? What did he want these people to do? He wanted them to go out of his room, right? And they did not, he don't want them to find out about his absence or about his identity, right? So yes, so the like what happened here? Yes, the furniture is attacking them, and which seems to be very strange. Next is Mrs. Hall almost fell down the stairs in hysterics. She was convinced that the room was haunted by spirits and that the stranger had somehow caused these to enter into a furniture, right? So she did not know that the stranger is there only throwing her furniture, but she thought that something strange has happened. And what did the spirit say she's talking about? What did the spirit say she's talking about? That maybe some supernatural element has come, some ghosts have come, some spirits have come, and they have entered the furniture, right? So yes, so she was convinced that the room was haunted by spirits and the stranger had somehow caused these, because he was here all these days and the furniture was quite old. It belonged to her mother and she's very upset, right? Now, yeah, they've called the neighbors also, and immediately, you know, like people who would be there to handle this witchcraft or this black magic that is happening. And what are the people also believe, because they are simple people, and they cannot find a logical explanation that why the furniture is moving around. So they're saying that some kind of ghost is there, or it's a witchcraft, or maybe some kind of magic is happening. That is why the furniture is moving. But witchcraft or not, when the news of the burglary at the clergyman's home became known, the strange scientist was strongly suspected of having had a hand in it. So here it shows that the villagers, they were not so simple at all. So they could put two and two together and come to the realization that, yes, that this man was not here at the time of the robbery. And it's quite possible here, because the clergyman is a very respected person. No villager would go to his house and commit a crime, right? This was his reputation in the village. So it is there that they believe that this man is a little strange, and what was he doing out of his room at such a, you know, like time of the night? So they strongly suspect him. But then we know what they do, right? What did they do? So they've called the village constable. Why do you think they've called the village constable? To arrest the man. Yes. And she wants to know what Mrs. Hall wants to know. Wants him to come out of his room. She wants him to tell her what he has been doing to her furniture, why the furniture is behaving so strangely. And one thing very, very important is, I want to know how it is you came out of an empty room and how you entered a locked room. So when we came in the morning, you know, like there, the room was locked. There was no one there. But yes, so I just opened the door and I wanted to look inside, and I saw the furniture, like the bed was cold and his bandages, clothes lying everywhere. So how did he come out? Right? So that is what they want to know. You were not there in the room. How did you come out? And yes, the room is there locked. So she was very, you know, like annoyed with the furniture behaving like this. And also she's locked the room. How did you come out of that? Okay. So we know how it happened here. So he was invisible. He entered the room and he started moving the furniture here and there and wanted the people to believe that. And now here he is showing his bandages. Okay. Right. Yes.